look for in boxing, being in them kind of fights. We'll both go about our job, getting the best shape we possibly can. Both bring our A game on the night, and we're both fighting for that Lonsdale belt of mine. We'll both want to take it home, but like I said, I'll make sure it's coming home with me. Derry will have other plans.
No, for a fact, if the right Derry Mathews turns up, there's no way Andy Crolla's going to live with me. And a lot of people might say, oh, he doesn't know what he's talking about. He's finished, he's at the end of his career, but just wait till fight night when that bell goes and he's on his own, and I'm going to take him places he's never been took before.
But that's it really. There's nothing other than that. It's nothing personal. It's just a job. Just a job, and it's just something we both want.
I hope everyone in Britain's underestimating me, because I know I'm right. My coach knows I'm right. Danny and Paul Lee know I'm right. And my dietitian, James Morton, everything's right. Everything's gone superb. My personal life's perfect. You know, obviously I've sacrificed living away from my girlfriend and my kids for 8 weeks, but you know, come fight night, I want to be in that ring, I want to think what I've sacrificed, what I've gone through to be in here. And wait to see the decision at the end, because in my eyes there's only one winner, and I'm going to bully him, I'm going to box him, I'm going to do whatever I have to do to win the fight, I'm going to win that British title fight.
It's nothing personal, it's just a job, and it's just something we both want. I haven't got to say, you know, prepare, make sure you're prepared, because I know he is. Derry's an experienced professional. He's been there, and I'm sure Danny and Paul will have him prepared to the best that he can be. And he's shown how serious he is. He's moved away from Liverpool up to Scotland. He's gone away over in hot weather to prepare for it. So he's preparing for this like it's his world title shot. So I haven't got a message for him as in like that. It's just, may the best man win on the night. You know, I'm doing a job here that I love, and you know, I look back a few years back when there was a time when I'd come off a few losses and my career wasn't, you know, didn't look as if it was going anywhere, and I just think, wow, you know, it's worth it. Life's good right now.
You know, I'm back to where I want to be. I'm happy again, and as George always told me, a happy fighter is a good fighter, and I believe I'm back. And you know, to me it won't be a shock, but to the boxing world it might be a shock when I beat Andy Crolla. So I've gone away, Danny's locked myself away in Scotland, he's looked after me up there, and you know, I'm locked away in an apartment, which was done by a sponsor, and you know, everything's gone great, the sparring's gone great so far, the training up there, locked away from home, locked away from the family, the sacrifice I've had to do is killing me, you know what I mean, but you know, come fight night, I know it's going to pay off, and I can thank everyone, you know, for helping me out.
I knew I could always, you know, I could get, you know, win British titles and stuff like that, win titles, being big fights. It was just, things wasn't right at the time, I was doing things wrong, and you learn, you live and learn, everything happens for a reason, and that was the path that I got took on, and I wouldn't change it.
I'm in the right frame of mind, my body's right, and come fight night, you'll see.
And the Manx Scouts thing, that always adds a bit of spice to it, but it'll be a good atmosphere. Derry's a great ticket seller. He'll bring a great crowd with him. I'll bring a great crowd, and you know, there won't be no trouble on the night. They'll both just support both of us. You know, they'll get behind the guy, and it's you know what I mean, that's what you want in boxing. You want a great atmosphere, you want people going away and saying, what a great atmosphere it was that night, what a great set of fans it was.
I've seen Crolla go off, grew up with Crolla the same, like, you know, the same. Around the same age and being on the same amateur shows and stuff like that. So anyway, I'm not against him. He's a wonderful lad. He's a great lad. He's a great champion. And I'll never disrespect any fighter. He's a gentleman away from the boxing ring. But you know, just has he ever been it? That's what comes into my mind. Has he ever been cut? I wouldn't say so. Has he ever been in a hard fight? So you know, he's there for the taking. He's never been in a hard fight, and I'm going to give him one of the hardest fights he's ever going to have in his life. And you know, maybe he might want to drop down to super featherweight, where I believe he belongs. And the reason he is British champion is because I was cut in training. Well, sorry, I was cut in the Scott Lawton fight. I was going to fight John Watson, and I got a bad cut, which reeled me out. And Andy Crolla stepped in to fight John Watson, and Andy Crolla won the British title. So, in my eyes, he's keeping it warm for me.
Being running 5 o'clock in the morning, in the gym at 12 o'clock, just being locked away in an apartment around the corner from me. He's just eating Liverpool boxing at the minute. No distractions up here, that's the thing. We needed to get him away from Liverpool, get his head right. It's a big, big chance for him. And his head's gone on, you know, he's doing everything faster.
The best Derry Mathews, it's a tough fight. He's very capable. We're preparing for the best Derry Mathews, the Derry Mathews that fought Steve Foster. I think everyone recognises that was his signature fight of his career. Came to Manchester in the Lion back then, and he did it. And I'm sure, I think you've seen with Stephen Smith recently, some fighters fight a lot better on the road. Anthony Crolla over the last 12 months has fought on the road. He's not fought in Manchester. This is his first fight for a long time. Derry Mathews has had a lot of fights in his hometown. I think maybe someone could say, this one who's fighting Gavin Rees, who's doing really well early on, caught Gavin Rees, good sharp right hand. And I think his best performance was away from home against Foster coming to Manchester. So he's not doing something that he hasn't done before. He's coming to Manchester, stroke Oldham, and won the title. And he did it in a great style, beating young Steve Foster that night. And that's the Derry Mathews we're preparing for. And it's sort of like sound the right way. I wouldn't say the pressure's on Anthony Crolla, but I don't think there's no pressure on Derry Mathews. I think there is, because he knows he's in a no-chance saloon. He knows he's got nowhere else to go after here. And this is his chance. He's hanging on by his fingernails of staying in boxing. Where does he go after here? Anthony Crolla, this has got to be a performance for him that makes a statement that, listen, I'm beyond domestic level, and I want your Kevin Mitchells and your Ricky Burns after this.
I'm new Anthony from when he made his debut. I mean, there's not much difference from now than when he was with Farnell. I've lost every one of his fights. I was at a debut, being at most, nearly every one of his fights. I've done my own work on him. We've seen a few chinks in the armour, and you know, we'll pick them out come fight night.
Derry's got a point to prove. He's got the bit between his teeth, and he feels he let down his supporters last time in Liverpool. And what I call a wounded animal is a dangerous animal, and I class Derry Mathews as a dangerous animal at the moment, and we're not taking him lightly. And if you just listen to the pedigree of the sparring that we've just got in for Anthony Crolla, that tells you everything about the preparations that we're doing. We really want to show everybody that we are serious about being British champion. Derry's a very, very good kid, good boxer. I've known Derry since he was age 12. I remember him loads of times. He used to come up at Shannon's when he was in the junior ABAs. He used to spar Owen Trainer. He's got a good pedigree, amateur pedigree, junior ABAs, junior Olympic champion. He's got good skills, and I'm very aware of what he brings to the table. And I'm not buying into this old Derry shot, or it's a joke, this and all that.
He's an experienced fighter now. You know, we got in a little bit of a slump, but we've got him back to doing what he does best. And boxing more. Been in Lanzarote for 12 days. Been running up the mountains, training 5 o'clock in the morning, high altitude, 7 mile, 6 mile runs, all up the mountain. It's been really, really hard, but you know, it'll pay off.
I'm not into all the trash talking part of it. I know things get said, and sometimes just to sell fights. And I understand that. And that's why it's nothing personal. That's why, like, if anything ever gets said to me, you know, don't take it personal. It's just one of those. It's one of those things, and if it helps sell the fight, it's a good thing. But once I get in there, honest, I promise. You know, my heart's as big as anyone's. I'll never ever give up. I promise that. I will always. If I get beat, I'll get beat because I got beat by the better man on the night, or just the better man. It won't be because I've not tried or I've not trained as hard as I can leading up to the fight. I'll give it absolutely everything.
He's my. I'd say one of my best kids I've ever trained. He lives and lives the life. I want it as much for Anthony as he wants it for himself. I just want him to see to the top. Everyone's written him off. He said he couldn't punch, couldn't do this, couldn't do that. And that's still going around. And I'm like, right, we'll show you. You say Derry Mathews is a dangerous animal. I think Anthony Crolla at the moment is a very focused, determined person to prove a lot of people wrong. He's got a bit of siege mentality, and he's going to absolutely I usually say about Squeak, but I feel with Anthony Crolla, he wants to hurt somebody. He's got a bit of a mean mood, bad intention about him, and that's not very Anthony Crolla, but he seems to be getting very focused, very in the zone, and he wants to be very he wants to hurt somebody. And to what does he have to do? Does he have to hurt somebody in the ring before people sit up and take heed of Anthony Crolla? And we know he's got a nickname, Anthony Million Dollar Crolla, but Anthony Crolla is the British champion, and the British champion, he wasn't getting no respect in and out of the ring.
I'm eating, living and sleeping, drinking and boxing, do you know what I mean? I'm doing everything right, my diet's perfect, I'm getting the best foods, I'm locked away, I'm the sacrifice, my phone's turned off come 8 o'clock, and you know, I'm just living the dream, I'm just doing it, and I know for a fact that everything what I'm doing in Scotland, the sacrifices, it's it's going to pay off.